don't be polite. If there are any questions you want to ask, ask anything. And if I fail to answer it, you have to say you didn't answer my question. That has to be ruthlessly honest.
Okay.
I have a lot of college professors come here and they write about the Venus Project in their books. Sociology professor and a marine scientist.
How about as far as countries
all
go?
All over the world. According to Peter Joseph, he said 50 million people now know about it. Of course, I had magazines write me and say, will you do an article for the Venus Project? I said, you better send me a copy of your magazine. And I'd look at it and say, well, this is a business magazine, a money magazine. And I criticize the money system and everything you stand for. They said, we'll run it anyway. So I said, do you agree not to change a word? They said, yes. That was the Irish entrepreneur from Ireland. And I don't want you to take my word. I just want you to know that every country that wrote about it, except the United States, Russia, Greece, Ireland, just from France. I built a car many years ago before you were born. It looked like this. It was called the Ultra. See it?
Uh-huh.
That's what it looked like, the real car. So, what else do I know? I did prefabricated houses, surgical instruments, all kinds of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Aircraft.
Wow.
Fire line.
Not as far as games, or
no.
Do you think humans will get bored?
This is a competitive system you live in.
Yeah.
And they teach that.
Mm-hmm.
But if you live in the, if the brain said, I do all the thinking, I want all the nutrients, the lungs would say, if I don't oxygenate the blood, you die as a brain. So the brain says to the lungs, what do you need? Everything you need. It goes to the kidneys, all the organs of the body get whatever the hell they need.
Mm-hmm.
There's no competition.
Do you believe it's natural for humans to be competitive? I know animals are competitive.
Is there such a thing as human nature? Is that what you mean? No, there is. We're not competitive.
Okay.
We're brought up to be that way.
So do you think animals and their environment are competitive because they don't have resources?
If animals have enough food, like cows are gentle, sheep are gentle, because there's more grass to go around. But if there was a little bit of grass, they'd be competitive. Same with humans. If they have access to the necessities of life, they don't kill and they don't steal. That is not natural. We live in an unnatural, artificial environment. For example, if a male has a lot of girlfriends and he's making love to all of them, he's called Don Juan. If a girl makes love to two guys, she's called a tramp. Who wrote the book, The Men? So the world you live in is artificial, very artificial, self-centered, egocentric, and dishonest. Every country. I wouldn't talk to them. We used to have gas lights. Edison invented the electric light. He had to educate people as to what the electric light is. Otherwise, they didn't know what the hell was going on. But the gas company said, sometimes when the gas blows out, a whole family dies. The gas company ran the sand. And they said that the electric light is 10 times powerful. When it blows out, I wouldn't want one in my house. They scared people because they wanted to sell gas. Do you understand what I'm saying? That goes to the automobile, women's rights. The women that marched for women's rights had rotten eggs thrown at them by normal people. And normal people mean screwed up. All normal people have been indoctrinated. If you don't understand me, if you were brought up in a Nazi culture as a baby, never saw anything else, you'd say, Heil Hitler. And you get a lump in your throat when you see this one sticker. You brought up in France, you'd be Vive la France, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So all people are perfectly well adjusted where they're coming from. That means if you're brought up in an uneducated region of the South, you're going to speak with a Southern accent and Southern mannerisms. And you might say, I'm going to give me a nigger and I'm going to kick his ass. And that's normal to where you're coming from. There's nothing wrong with you. There's no such thing as good or bad people. they're made that way by culture. I'm ruthlessly honest.
Oh.
Okay. I asked Einstein whether he believed in God once. He said, which one? They're all so different. I said, I used to go to church. And I don't know if you're Christian.
I'm open-minded. I don't really have
The minister was telling me how wonderful God was. And he knew everything. He made every galaxy, every bug, everything. So I said, well, he says also he makes it rain to make the plants grow. That's how wonderful he is. So I raised my hand. I said, why does it rain at sea? He got mad at me. He said, hold on your hand. He beat the shit out of me. My hands, real bad. Because if he was smart, he says, you know, that's interesting. I hadn't thought about it. But he got mad. He was a stupid man. He wasn't bright. He should not be in charge of a church. Because he said, my kingdom is not of this world. It's up there. So I said, you forgot the Lord's Prayer. Jesus said, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. There's no money in heaven, no private ownership, no business, no competition. Mm-hmm. So I said, the Venus Price is the nearest thing to what religion talks about. Religion talks about everything, and people give lip service to the teachings of Christ. Mm-hmm. When the rich man came to him and said, could I enter the kingdom of heaven? He said, the same chance a camel has going to the eye of a needle. I said, what do you want me to do? Give all your surplus money to the poor and follow me. Guy said, no thanks. Now, all the religious people are part of the money system. All the churches talk about money. They have pride of their big chandeliers and organs. They've sold out to the money system. The Catholic Church blesses war tanks in this country, and in Italy they bless the war tanks, and they bless the soldiers. It's in the Bible says, thou shalt not kill. Mm-hmm. Doesn't say, sometimes it's all right. Yeah. So I don't see Christianity. Larry King once said to me, what do you think of Christianity? I said, it's a wonderful idea. When are they putting it into practice? I speak in church sometimes, why scientists believe in God. And the second lecture is why scientists don't believe in God. I get both sides. And they turn around. I've had Catholic priests come here with a cross around their neck. I say, I wouldn't wear that if I were you. He said, why not? I said, that's what man did to Christ. It has nothing to do with the teachings of Christ. I've never met a Christian. In hitchhiking across the country, a very heavy set woman with a brand new car opened the door part of the way. She said, are you a Christian? Before she picked me up for a ride. I says, of course. I said, what else? So she says, get in. Then I fell asleep and she hit me in the ribs. She said, you're not sleeping in my car. I said, what do you want me to do? You're going to sing all the way to Texas, Jesus loves me, that I know, cause the Bible tells me so. I had to sing. Well, she was too stupid to understand the teachings of Christ. It says, when a man strikes you, turn the other cheek, and these assholes go to war.
Yeah.
So soldiers to me are killing machines, they're not human beings. Because if they thought about it, they'd never do that. War is big business. You make a lot of money selling war tanks, ammunition. A friend of mine was a pilot. He said he flew over a German munition dump 8 times and ordered not to bomb it. He was an American. He says he never knew why he wasn't supposed to bomb it. After the war, he found out that DuPont, you know DuPont Corporation, had holdings in the German company called I.J. Farben. That's why he was able to bomb it. So money, all that is not in your school books. You understand? Mm-hmm. It should be in all the school books.
Yeah.
History books are bullshit. They're mm-hmm. lies. Because everybody in the book does the right thing. Nobody makes mistakes. In a real book, people will tell you their shortcomings, the stupid things they did. Now, that doesn't deal with real problems.
Mm-mm.
If you send care packages to an earthquake zone, what do they do after the care package mm-hmm. is used up?
Right.
So we would train people on how to take care of the earth. If you destroy the forest, U.S. Army dumped 65 tons of nerve gas into the ocean off the coast of Miami. Are you familiar with that? Should be in your school books.
Yeah.
It's never made it. So I don't like managed news. You know what I mean?
Hi.
Unfortunately, things were so bad in Russia, men used to pull boats along the river, and that people were deprived of food, and things were so bad that they revolted against the government. People do not think about anything else. If they're working, have a car and a home,